wonder how television gets made? Well, at the Monash TV studio, you'll be the person making it. The TV studio is where you'll learn how to work both in front of and behind the camera, on news reports, panel shows, creative projects, and everything in between. The TV studio came up quite a bit in the degree. What was great is you actually got experience anchoring, reading news, using the teleprompters, and it got to the point where we actually were doing full news broadcasts as well. As part of Mojo, which is the amazing student news website here at Monash, the reason that I was in this TV studio so much was because of this project called The Struggle. It was a satirical news show and it was completely the brainchild of the people in the degree. We all got together, we found a bunch of news stories, wrote jokes about them, set everything up. There'd be technicians here to help us, staff here to help us, and you know, take it away, edit it all up, and then it would go to air every week. I think just getting in front of a camera is actually really important. There's a bunch of tiny things you don't think about, like what clothes work well, how you have to do your hair, and I know that all sounds sort of minute, but when you're sitting there in an internship and it finally comes time for you to jump in front of the camera, you want to be ready, you want to know exactly what you should be doing, and being able to actually have that experience here, even just being able to see yourself in a news camera, is such an invaluable experience. If you're obsessed with breakfast radio, or maybe want to be Triple J's next Hottest 100 host, then you probably belong in the Monash Radio Studios. With its soundproof rooms and high-quality condenser microphones, this is where you'll learn everything, from how to research and produce your own podcast, to how to just keep a conversation flowing live on air. Everything you need is here in terms of recording. There's editing booths where you can sort of lock yourself away and just get work done. You have the capacity to be live on air here. It's got everything. You can write as many radio scripts as you want in a classroom, and they can, you know, be very well written on paper, but you just don't know what things are going to sound like once you start reading them out. So being able to sit here in front of a mic, writing my scripts, recording it, editing it into videos or podcasts or whatever it might be, it gave me a real sense of actually how to script that. And the moment you get into internships when you're being asked to script it, having that sort of innate sense that you've built up over the years by having access to a space like this, I think is very valuable. The amount of times that I would just block out a few hours, you know, a couple of friends, we'd have just like a weird idea for a podcast and we'd get together and hang out and record it. Things that accidentally ended up being assignments because it turns out it met all the criteria. Now, to make your story sing, you're going to need to get the most out of your content. That's where the editing suites come in. The Monash Media Lab contains 8 private, soundproof, edit and voice recording suites where you'll practice putting together your stories over a wide range of mediums. Being able to edit your own stories is incredibly important nowadays. More and more, the industry is all about video journalism. So you're filming, you're reporting, you're writing, and you're editing everything together, probably all in the space of one day. And it really opens up doors when it comes to doing your own projects. If you know how to edit, there's nothing stopping you from having an idea for a documentary, going out, filming everything, interviewing people, and coming and sitting down, having total creative control over the editing process, not needing to hire a bunch of people. Essentially, you're making yourself a one-stop shop, and suddenly there isn't a bunch of obstacles standing in your way. I edited heaps of different projects here in these rooms, from everyday news stories, going out to protests, things like that, to my longer form documentary for my final year. That was probably my favourite piece of work. I ended up going along to an abattoir protest held by extreme animal activists, filmed them the whole way through. I came back here, sat down and probably spent weeks going through, you know, hours and hours of footage, putting everything together meticulously, and ended up with a piece of work that I was really proud of. And I ended up entering that project into the Young Walkley Awards, where I won the Student Journalist of the Year for 2019. When you study a Bachelor of Media Communication, you can choose from 4 specialisations: journalism, media, public relations, and screen. Thanks so much for joining me on this tour of the Monash Media Lab. Honestly, it was amazing to be back in my old home. As you've seen, if you want to work in media and communication, this is the place to be. Get involved, get your hands dirty, take advantage of all the amazing experts and experiences that are at your fingertips here. Before you'll know, you'll be ready for your first job in the field.